closest emergency exit may not necessarily be the way that you entered the performance hall. At the orchestra level, there are additional exits on the sides of the hall. At the balcony level, there are additional exits at the rear of the hall, near the choir loft. The use of any photography or recording devices is strictly prohibited, out of respect for the performers. Thank you and enjoy the performance.
Hello, 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 hello. Hello, everybody. Welcome to tonight's concert. My name is Chris Lamont, and I am the Director of Operations at NYO Canada. Now, we have a very, very special program for you guys tonight. I'm not going to give anything away, but there may be some surprises and some exciting stuff to see. And before we bring on our first group, please allow us at NYO to thank the J.P. Bickell Foundation, the Isabel Bader Center for the Performing Arts, and Queen's University for supporting NYO Canada's Chamberfest concert series. Without them, we could not provide free concerts for the Kingston community and the opportunity to perform in front of the crowd of all of you today. So please enjoy the concert and have a great evening.
Good evening. Tonight we will be playing the Allegro Moderato from Dvorak's String Quartet No. 13 in G major. Dvorak was a Czech composer who is famously known for the time he spent working in the United States. Now this quartet was written upon his return to Prague in 1895 and has lots of American influences as well as inspirations from nature. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening, everyone. My name is Bobby, and we are the Barbies. For we are playing Samuel Barber's bewitching and beautiful summer music. All this talk of summer music, it's sure getting hot in here. The piece was commissioned by the Chamber Music Society of Detroit for the principal wind players of the Detroit Symphony Orchestra, who premiered the piece in 1956. The $2,000 commission was not given to Barber from a singular source, but rather members of the Chamber Music Society and their audiences would give donations of $10 to $20 each. This way, audience members had a sense of ownership and a real attachment to this new and revolutionary work they could call their own. After the premiere, the New York Wind Quintet and the principal players from the Philadelphia Orchestra would share this piece across North America and the world, which resulted in its exposure and popularity. As this is Barber's only woodwind quintet, he strived to extract the maximum potential for expression and technical effects from each instrument. Summer music is in one movement and consists of recurring themes, recalling the peaceful and lively nature of one's memories in the summertime. Please enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. By show of hands, who here has gone and seen the Mona Lisa? Sorry about that. The Mona Lisa. So that's not a lot of you. Well, for those of you with your hands down, and that's the majority, don't worry. It's actually your lucky day, because instead of you having to travel 3.7 thousand miles to go and see that small, kind of average-looking painting, our cellist Matthew, you can give us a little wave. There you go. He's gone to the extreme lengths to bring it all the way here for you today. Now, take a really good look at it, if you can. Everyone who sees this painting for the first time always asks the exact same question. Why is this mysterious face, Miss Mona Lisa? Why is it the most revered face in the entire world, other than, of course, Scarlett Johansson and myself? It actually has nothing to do with the painting itself, or the fact that it was made by the famous Leonardo da Vinci. It's actually its theft that launched this relatively unknown work into legend. Long story short, in 1911, Louvre employee Vincenzo Perugia and his henchmen waltzed in one night and snatched it right off the wall. As you can imagine, everyone went crazy. People were looking for it for 2 years until smart guy, he tries to sell it. Gets caught, painting is restored, and is safe ever since. So, you might be asking, why am I telling you all of this? It seems pretty random, right? Well, it's because our piece, Dinuk, Wijeratne's Disappearance of Lisa Gherardini, tells a tale of the Mona Lisa, from its painting to the heist, and then to present day. It's a highly theatrical work with lots of fun twists and turns, and we even have a surprise guest will be coming on and playing our security guard turned theft, Vincenzo Perugia. There's also going to be some pauses in the music as we tell the story, so please don't clap for those. The ending is going to be like really obvious. So you're not going to miss it, I promise. It's not like some slow like fade out ending. It's pretty epic. Anyways, without further ado, sit back, relax, and enjoy as we steal the Mona Lisa.